Hello, I'm Ryan Fluker. I am the photographer on the Rolling Stone Boy Genius shoot. Cover, whatever.
Hi, I'm Jared Elner, and I'm the stylist on the Boy Genius Rolling Stone cover.
My name is Alexandra Mitchell, and I'm a vintage specialist who assisted Jared in making the shoot happen.
The reason why I said yes to this cover was because it was three queer ladies that I really think are fucking awesome. Having them reinterpret a kind of iconic cover that Nirvana originally had done, I thought that it was really contemporary and cool to do. If it wasn't them, I probably wouldn't have been interested. They have similar mentalities of kind of fuck the system and not necessarily caring about what is like cool or hip, which ends up being cool and hip.
The main component in this is humor, and I feel like they both have such a good use of comedy and lightheartedness about fashion. They just don't give a shit, and in the coolest way. And I felt like I wanted to make sure that that was really, really highlighted.
The concept kind of first came together almost 2 years ago. And initially I was talking to the band like, you know, what if we redid this shoot, specifically the Mademoiselle one, and what if we did it with like the exact pieces? Because they felt attainable. I mean, so much vintage is, you know, it's like, oh, I'll never find that. But in my mind, I was like, okay, I'll find the Jean Meyer scarves, the Todd Oldham knit, there's a Dries Van Noten knit, and a Joan Vass knit. And I should have known better, because finding vintage on demand is like impossible. So the scarves, I was lucky enough to connect with the designer and get some of the original scarves, Jean Meyer. That he made in the 90s. I feel super lucky to have connected with Gene. He lives full-time in Morocco and shipped some of the original scarves to us to use. And that was really exciting because it felt like we had a little piece of the original shoot beyond just the concept. And for sweaters, we pulled some vintage ones that just felt right. You know, I felt like kind of the closer you get to making them look identical, sometimes the less right they feel. Like, oh, the colors are right, but the stripes are wrong, stuff like that. Initially, the idea was like, oh, we have to make it one-to-one. You know, we have to like be in this image. And I think that evolved organically with so much of like Jared's great pulls that we used.
The first thing I decided on was, maybe not decided, but started the hunt for the perfect suits. I feel like this whole thing revolved around like the perfect matching pinstripe suits. So that's where I started. I kind of hit the ground running looking for the perfect fit. I mean, I love the Gucci suits for the cover. It was really important for us to have three matching menswear suits to get that like exact silhouette that they had. Those are a favorite. I feel like there's so much thought that went into all of this. Like, there are so many little details. Everybody put their heads together and made sure that there were so many moments and little hidden treasures throughout the whole thing.
So I pulled all of the Jean Meyer scarves that were worn as skirts, and also all of the pins and badges and brooches. I sourced them all individually, and they all reference different lyrics. From Boy Genius, from their EP, and from Lucy, Phoebe, and Julian's solo work, and from the new album. So there are Easter eggs in there. Phoebe's The End Is Near pin is really good. You know, it's funny because the original cover was working against this idea of like being buttoned up when you're not normally buttoned up. And it's almost like we had to double negative that. And it's like, okay, we're gonna be Nirvana, but actually we're gonna be ourselves.
The thing I love most about musicians is they come with a vision. So I feel like most times it is dropping into some type of character, whether I'm taking it there or if they have that vision themselves. It sort of always feels like dress up and play with musicians. So either way, I'm down. But I do like a combination, leaning into what people are good at and what they're known for and also pushing it to something new.
I mean, when I look at the image, to me, I love the contrast of, you know, we know who this band is, we know what they stand for, and it's not suits, and it's not being buttoned up. So to me, there was such a great contrast there. When it was Nirvana wearing the looks, you know, it's men wearing skirts who don't always wear skirts, although I think Kurt Cobain did wear dresses fairly regularly. I'm not sure how often, but the contrast was there. And I felt that even though boygenius is a band of women, that you still felt that difference, even when they're wearing feminine silhouettes and feminine colors and feminine prints. It still felt like there was a pull, yeah.
As someone that really loved photography, you know, Rolling Stone is one of the magazines that you look at. And so as a photographer and as a queer person and as a non-binary person, I find it that like this is the kind of work that I want to be doing. And so, you know, it's a cool thing to be a part of.
It's such a beautiful reinterpretation to create the same image with completely different identities and completely different people for a new generation. And it starts conversations that have been had and stopped and will start again. It feels like a very special moment, and I'm really honored to be a part of it.